I'm back. What's up? It's me, the chemical dude, H202. Whoops, it's been 6 months since I uploaded anything. My bad. Today is going to be a totally different kind of video. I'm going to be breaking down and analyzing the lyrics for Mr. Self-Destruct. I'm not super great at the music theory side of these things, so if you want analysis on that stuff, I would suggest you check out Ixie's video on this song and other songs from the Downward Spiral, as well as other Nine Inch Nails songs. Her channel is going to be linked down below in the description. I just want to say, if you're expecting jokes, or anything, you shouldn't. The album covers a lot of topics like depression, drug abuse, sex, suicide, so this is going to be a more serious video, but I'm hoping, you know, people will like it. If you're easily upset by any of the topics I mentioned, I would recommend you click off this video, because this is gonna really bother you if you don't like that. If you can't handle that stuff. So, let's get into it. I am a huge fan of Nine Inch Nails. Anyone who knows me is well aware that I think The Downward Spiral is one of the best albums of all time. It's a fantastically structured album that details exactly what the name implies. It is a downward spiral of a character falling deeper into depression, addiction, and self-destructive habits, which, namely, the first song, Mr. Self-Destruct, perfectly details. It's a perfect opening. It serves almost as a thesis statement for the rest of the album. Let me explain. In The Downward Spiral, each song tackles a different theme or idea. You have the disillusionment with religion and God and heresy. You have addiction to sex, using it as a coping mechanism, and Closer, etc., etc. Mr. Self-Destruct, we're taken on a tour of all these themes. We're giving a surface-level glimpse at what the other songs are going to delve deeper into later. So, let's take a look at what it's really saying. The opening of the song makes it very clear that this Mr. Self-Destruct is an analogy for the character's self-destructive habits. I am the voice inside your head, I'm the lover in your bed, the sex that you provide, the hate you try to hide. Each line is followed up with a whisper of, and I control you. Almost like it's a thought in the back of your mind, that voice in the head that's always going to tell you these bad things. You aren't enough, you aren't happy. You need these things, you need these habits, because nothing else is going to make you happy. The idea that this voice is bringing some escapism and momentary relief from the pain that it is actually inflicting is further cemented in the chorus, I take you where you want to go, which would probably refer to the addictions and habits that this character has, drugs, sex, anything that he can use to make himself feel good or okay, to go to a place where he's happy, taking him where he wants to go. Then that same voice, next line, says, I give you all you need to know. The voice is the one telling that we're not good enough, that we're bad, that we need to know that we're terrible, and this voice will always be here to remind us. Next line, I drag you down, I use you up, is a pretty obvious line of what it's saying. It's pretty literal, saying that this voice is what is bringing you down. It is what is hurting you. It drags you further down the spiral and makes you feel worse and worse until you hit the bottom. It uses up your energy and your emotions. Everything you had, everything that you could give, everything that was good, gets used up and thrown away by this voice that controls you and only serves to destroy you. This next verse is pretty heavily based around the loss of faith in religion, this realization that God can't be real, the feeling of abandonment and hatred of religion, because how could God possibly be real? How could this loving God that we're told is real allow us to feel this sort of pain and loneliness? With the line, "I speak religion's message clear, I am denial, guilt, and fear. Religion and the things we're told are good want us to suppress ourselves," according to the song. I'm not gonna give my own opinion. The song is basically saying that whether it's some sexual deviance that you will see later in Closer, whether it's something about ourselves that we're taught is wrong, it's using religion to talk about this idea of how we can sometimes suppress ourselves and hate ourselves because we've been conditioned to think something about us is wrong. The next lines, "I am the praise of the naive," that's pretty much saying that anyone who does believe in religion would be stupid or naive. They don't see the world how it truly is. They don't see the evil or the hatred that this character has opened his eyes and he's seen. Then it's followed with, "I am the lie that you believe," furthering this idea that religion and God is a lie. After another chorus, we're suddenly thrust into this slower, softer section of the song. It's like a low point, almost. The phrase, "You let me do this to you," is repeated over and over throughout this, followed by a whisper, "I am the exit." The first phrase seems to allude to maybe a moment of clarity in the protagonist's minds, realizing what's happening and really scared of how far he's fallen. And, you know, this idea that you do these things to yourself, the idea that maybe it's his fault for that he feels these things. Then "I am the exit" starts building. It starts out inaudible, but then it gets louder, and it gets louder, as almost like it's the thought of suicide or self-harm getting more and more pervasive in this character's head. Next verse goes over the character's addictions, and while I can't say that there's a song later in the album that's gonna explicitly talk about this like I could with, you know, religion and sex like I can with the others, the verse here seems to imply that not only is our protagonist addicted to sex as we see in Closer, but that he uses drugs, referring to the needle in his vein and the high he can't sustain. The drugs that make him feel better for a little while, but it's not gonna last, that he needs more and more and more, and that it's never really gonna make him feel better, but it's all he can think to do. Then we jump into our final set of ideas, being extremely explicit about depression and suicide. "I am the bullet in the gun," is the thought of killing himself. "I am the truth from which you run," again, going back to the idea in the chorus that the voice is giving us all we need to know. That it's telling the truth that they try to avoid, but they can't get away from. Then we get, "I am the silencing machine. I am the end of all your dreams." The final words before we're going to be put into another chorus for the last time. And it's pretty fitting that these would be the last lines of the verse, since they are very final statements that basically say, your life is over, your dreams are over, you are over. So overall, I'd say Mr. Self-Destruct is a really fantastic introduction to the Downer Spiral. It's extremely blunt, stating exactly what's going to come forward, the ideas, the aggressive nature, the pain that's going to be in these songs are all given to you in this song. As I said earlier, it's a thesis statement almost. It is saying this is what's about to happen. This is what you're about to see. And I can't think of a better way to introduce this album, honestly. It's great. I hope you enjoyed this video, even though it's so ridiculously different from my normal stuff. If you enjoyed, I'd appreciate if you liked or even subscribed, and let me know in the comments if you enjoyed it and you want to see more of this kind of stuff. I know it's a major tonal shift from the normal memes and stuff, but I love music and I love lyrics and I love delving into these ideas, honestly. And I never really thought to make a video about it before, but I honestly really kind of enjoy this. So I hope you enjoy it, and I hope that if I make another one, I'll see you in the next one. And if not, I'll see you in whatever I post next. And thanks for watching. Bye.